Hi, good evening, kids. Good evening. Swastika, Shekina, Ami, Mabry, Ami. That is Ami.
Good evening, teacher.
Yes. Swastika, Ami, Maverick, Shekina, can you all switch on your videos? Yes, good, Shekina. Swastika? Ami, okay. Swastika, Maverick, you both? Good. Maverick is laughing. Swastika? Swastika? Where are you? Very good, Swastika. Swastika also on, no? Okay, let's start your presentation. Can you all see the screen?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Can you all see the screen?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay. Fine. Today we are going to study about what? Everyone wants to speak. Today we are going to study about what? Read this one.
Introducing the computer.
Sorry, I can't Okay. I'm going to start a screen sharing. Okay, what's the topic of this chapter?
Introducing
to computer.
Introduction to computer.
Introduction to the computer. Okay, let's move to this slide. Okay, what's the heading? Introduction to computer. Let's study about what? Introduction to computer. So first slide. Here, that's a picture, no? What's that?
What's computer system.
Yeah, computer system. Computer system is what? What's meant by computer system? What's meant by computer system?
All the parts of the computer.
Yeah, very good. Shekina, very good. All the parts of a computer. There are many parts, no? Can you all tell me the parts one by one? What's the first one? What's this?
CPU.
Yeah, CPU, but it's not actually CPU. It's a system, you know. Very first earlier class, I told no. What's that? System unit.
System unit. CPU na enna system unit appdi solluvanga.
System unit means CPU means inside the system unit there is a small chip. That chip only we call what? CPU. What's the full form of CPU? Central processing unit. What's the full form of CPU? What is the full form of CPU? Central processing unit.
Processing unit.
center, partitioning,
processing unit.
Unit.
Processing unit.
Okay. With me, tell me all. Center. Unmute all your mic. Okay. Center.
Center.
Processing. Unit.
Unit.
Yeah. CPU means central processing unit. Okay. Processing device, right? So which type of device? It's a processing device. I want to unmute you all. Can you all unmute? Everyone wants to speak with me.
Okay, teacher.
Okay. What's the next one? What's this?
Speaker.
Speaker is an input device or output device?
Output.
Yeah, speaker is a output device. Why are you telling speaker is an output device? Why we are telling speaker is an output device? Because we hear sound from speaker, no? Yeah, okay, very good. What's this device? What's this?
Monitor.
Monitor. Monitor is an input device or output device?
Output.
Output. Which is the main output device? Yeah, which is the main output device?
Monitor.
Okay. Last class I told, no?
Monitor.
Yeah, monitor. Monitor is a main output devices in computer systems. Okay?
Okay.
Next. What is this?
Keyboard.
Keyboard is an input device or output device? Keyboard is an input device or output device? Yeah, it's an input device, right? Shekina, why I keep quiet? Keyboard is an input device. Because we are typing letters by using keyboard, it will be shown where? In monitor, no? In screen. So, keyboard is an input device. Okay? Okay, next. What's this one?
Mouse.
Mouse. Mouse is an input device, output device, or processing device?
Processing device.
No, mouse is a processing device. Is it a processing device?
Input device.
Yeah, mouse is an input device. We are click and drag and everything doing by mouse, no? So, mouse is a input device. We are clicked by using mouse. It will show where? In monitor. So, mouse is a output device. Input device. Okay. Mouse also input device. Okay.
Input.
I'm going to do a small like a homework to you all. First, draw this one. Draw this picture. Quickly draw this picture. Don't name these pictures. Just draw on it. Do it quickly.
Okay.
Finished.
Yes.
Okay. Finished, teacher.
We'll move to the next slide. Okay, here. I'm going to study about what? Difference between man and computer. Okay? Okay. No need to write. Yeah, difference between man and computer. No need to write. Just listen, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Difference between man and the computer. First we'll see man and after we'll see computer. Human being have feelings. We are human beings. We have feelings. Feelings means we have sadness, happiness, and cry. Sometimes we'll cry, sometimes we'll smile, and sometimes we'll dance. Everything we will be having feelings, no? But computer, it has no feelings. Computer can't smile, computer can't cry, and computer can't feel sadness, and computer can't feel happiness and everything, no? So this is the first difference between man and computer. What's the first difference?
Man and computer.
Yeah, what's the first one is human being have feelings, but computer has no feelings. Yeah, feelings means what? Feelings.
The things will feel.
Yeah, the things will we can do. Especially we do. That means we can cry, no? But computer can cry. Computer can cry.
No, teacher.
You can't, no? Yeah. Computer can smile.
No, teacher.
You all are smiling, no?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you all smile, please? Okay, nice, very nice. Okay, human beings have feelings, but if I am telling to computer, can you smile? What computer will do? Computer smile? No. Yeah, computer can't smile. That's what the first example. You all can smile, but computer can't smile. That's what we are calling feelings. Different from feelings. Okay, clear first point. Clear. Okay, good.
Yes, clear.
Have mind extra intelligence. Human have mind extra intelligence. It doesn't have intelligence. That means computer also intelligence, but it doesn't have more intelligence when compared to human. Why, Swastika? Do you have any questions? Swastika? Okay, good. Have mind extra intelligent means we have extra intelligent means we can work alone, no? But computer, we want to guide them. Human, we want to guide to computer. So that's what here they are telling. Have mind extra intelligence. We have extra intelligence, but computer doesn't extra intelligence mind. Clear?
Clear, teacher.
Next, man can do work by themselves. Man can do work by themselves, but computer without the human instruction, they can't work. They follow commands only. Okay? Without the human instruction, they can't work. But we can work without anyone's instruction, no? Yeah. For example, in your exams, you are doing without instruction, no? Teacher won't help, no? But computer, if you are going to do a work by using computer, you want to give commands to the computer. Otherwise, it won't work. Clear?
Yes,
teacher.
Can understand the corrected and wrong things, so but computer can't understand the correct and wrong things. Without the human instruction, they can't understand the which is correct and which is wrong. Clear?
Yes. Quiz.
Yeah, quiz we'll do. It's the last slide. We'll do quiz later. Okay, wait. Yeah. Next. Can learn and forget things. Human can learn new things and sometimes they will forget. No? But computer sharp memory store everything. Okay. Okay. Clear. Okay, Swastika, Maverick, switch on your videos. Swastika, Maverick, switch on. Okay, good. Semi, it's gone. Okay, are you clear about this one? Difference between man and computer?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, okay. Can you all read one by one these points? First, Shekina, then Swastika, and finally, Maverick. Okay? Unmute you all.
Teacher, which point?
This one, man. This one, man. First point. Shakina, read this first point.
Human beings have feelings.
Yeah. Read it again. Computer.
It has no feelings. Okay, teacher, finish, teacher.
Finish, no? Next, Swastika, can you read? Swastika?
Yes, has meat, eats a internet.
Sorry? Yeah. Have mind extra intelligence. Have mind extra intelligence. Okay. What's the next point? Computer, read this point. Swastika?
Yes.
Read this one. It doesn't.
It doesn't. Have intelligence.
Say intelligence.
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 Okay, very good. Next, Maverick. Maverick. Read third point. Maverick.
Can do one by themselves.
Without any command.
Any command.
Okay. What's the third point of computer?
They follows command.
Yeah. They follows commands. Okay. You three clear about this slide? Huh?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Then shall I move to next slide?
Yes. Huh? Yes.
Okay, teacher.
Okay. Okay. Don't consider about this paragraph. Just tell me, what is software? I think last five class, I think this one. What is software?
Computer instruction. I'm just saying.
Sorry?
Computer software or simple.
Don't read this one. I'm just asking, what is software?
Collection of data or computer instructions.
Okay, Shekina, what is software? physically
can't touch. Teach anything spelling.
What is software? Physically, we can't touch, but we can see. See?
Yes.
Where are you all? Can you all switch on your videos? Okay. Next, what is hardware? Then what is hardware? What is hardware?
Hardware
opposite to the software. What is hardware? So opposite to the software. Okay. Hardware means physically we can touch and we can see. Clear? It's a small definition for hardware and software. Clear? Okay. Then Swastika, can you tell me what is software? Physically we can't touch, we can see. That's called what? Software. Then what is hardware? Shekina, what is hardware?
We can touch and see.
We can physically, we can touch and see. Okay, give me example for hardware. Anyone, can you all give me example for hardware?
Keyboard, mouse, monitor.
Yeah, keyboard, mouse, monitor, system unit, etc. Okay, then tell me one example for software. One example for software. Notepad. Very good. Check in. Very good. Notepad, WordPad, Paint, Tux Paint. These all are example for software, no? Okay. Very good. No need to write this one. Okay. Let's do a small activity. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Read this one. Identify parts of the computer system. Identify the parts of a computer. No need to write in your writing book. Just tell me orally. Yeah? Okay. What's this part? What's the part of the computer? Sorry. This is.
This.
Monitor.
Monitor. That's monitor?
Monitor.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a monitor. This is monitor. Okay. Then what is this?
Speaker.
Yeah, it's a speaker. That's speaker. That's the speaker. Which one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the 5 options. No. Which one is speaker?
Three.
Yeah. Number 3 is a speaker. Okay. Then what is this? What's a CPU? CPU or system unit?
System unit.
Yeah, system unit. Where's the system unit in right? That's the system unit.
Number five.
Okay. Here, yeah, there's a system unit. Okay. Then what is this?
Mouse.
Where's mouse?
Second one.
Then finally, what is this?
Keyboard.
Last. Can you again name these computer parts?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
What's the first picture?
System unit.
Yeah, system unit. Then second picture?
Speaker.
Third picture?
Monitor.
This one?
Keyboard.
Finally, this is
mouse.
Mouse. Okay. then I think everyone clear about the computer system, no? Main computer systems. Clear? Yeah, okay. With that hope, I'll move to the next slide. Okay. Give me a minute. Okay. We'll do a quiz. Shall we do?
Yes.
I'll send a quiz link in your WhatsApp group. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Recording a post pannunga. Recording a post pannunga. Here, I all got this link, quiz link. So come every check in. Are you three here? No. Then we'll start the quiz. Start. Swastika, finished?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Let's see, first, Maverick. Yeah, first Maverick, second Shekina, and the third Swastika. Okay? Shall we see the questions one by one? Now?
Teacher.
Okay.
Okay, teacher. Okay, miss.
Here, this first question. What is software? What is software? Which one is the correct answer?
First one. Any set of instruction that tells the hardware what to do.
Yeah, software is what? any set of instruction that tells the hardware what to do. Without the software instruction, hardware won't work. Without the hardware, software won't work. So if you have a computer, you need both hardware and software. With that, also wanted liveware. Okay, liveware means who? Human beings. Human beings are liveware. Without these wares, we can't work with computer. Okay, clear? Swastika?
Yes, teacher.
Swastika, question. Clear, Swastika?
Yes, miss.
Okay, very good. Next, I think everyone correct other questions. What is hardware? What's hardware?
Is any part of your computer that has a physical
structure? Is any part of your computer that has a physical structure? Physical structure means you can touch physically.
Input.
Yeah, input, processing, output, these kind of things are what? Physical?
Yeah.
Okay. Next, what's the picture of this?
Input.
Yeah, is it a keyboard? Huh? Is it a keyboard, right?
Yes, teacher.
Keyboard is a input device. Input. Yeah. Okay, good. Next, can save five words.
Pen drive.
Yeah, pen drive is a storage device. That's what we are calling. We can save works in storage. It's a storage device. No, we can store data inside that pen drive. We can remove this pen drive and use another computer also. But some kind of storage devices, we can't remove and use another computer. Okay, we'll study those things later. Huh? Next. What is this? What's the picture
keyboard.
Then what is this?
Monitor.
Monitor is an input device or output device?
Output.
Yeah, monitor is an input output device. Motherboard?
Input.
Motherboard is an input device. Motherboard means inside the system unit, there is a small board. Inside the board only, we can see the CPU, Central Processing Unit. That Central Processing Unit plays in a motherboard. So motherboard also, we can tell what? Kind of a device. Okay. Next, what is this? Seventh question.
Mouse.
Yeah, mouse is an input device or output device?
Input.
Very good. Mouse is an input device. Then what is this? Eighth question.
Speaker.
Then what's the device shown in the picture?
Printer
is an input or output device.
Output.
Yeah, why we are telling printer is an output device?
Use pictures.
Yeah, we are scan some document, something, and it will be get as a paper. We get as a paper from printer. We have a output called paper, no? Paper we are getting. So printer is a output device. It output something. Clear?
Teacher.
The final question, what is the device shown in the picture?
A scanner.
Scanner, yeah. We scan a document and it will be shown via monitor. In screen we can see. Okay?
Output.
Yeah. Sorry, is it the output device?
No.
No, it's an input device. Scanner is an input device. Okay? Yes, scan something inside and it will shown via in output device monitor. So we are input something by scanner and it will shown output as a monitor. Okay?
Okay,
very good. Okay. Are you okay with this quiz?
Yes, teacher. Yes, teacher. Teacher, we want some more.
Some more. Next class, I'll do more than 20 to 30 questions.
Huh? Okay, teacher.
Okay. You all are good students, no? Okay, how are you all? Huh? Are you interesting in this class or it's too boring?
Interesting, teacher.
Teacher. Sit. You sit.
Yes, teacher.
No, it's boring.
So, Sastika, is it boring?
No, no.
No. Then Maverick is telling it's boring. Sit.
No, teacher. It's interesting. It's
interesting, no? So, same, you all are staying interesting. Okay. Shall we watch a video?
Huh? Okay, teacher.
Which video you want? You all want which video? Sagina, Maverick. Ah, sorry? Cartoon. You want a cartoon?
Yes.
No, no, no. It's not seeing cartoon time. It's studying time, no. So we'll watch a video related to the computer. Ah? Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Smile, smile and tell. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. That's Swastika. That's your smile, Swastika. Then we'll watch a video. Can you all hear the sound?
No, teacher.
Can't.
No, teacher.
No, teacher.
Okay, give me a minute. Give me a minute.
I heard that you are a very smart machine.
Yes, I am, Rini.
What is a machine, Kliko?
Well, Rini, machines are man-made things that make our work easy. We use many types of machines in our daily life.
Tell me about some of the machines that we use daily.
We use a washing machine to wash clothes, a television to watch serials, movies, or sports, a fridge to keep food.
What kind of jobs can a computer?
Watch another video, okay?
Okay.
This is a computer.
Kliko, the computer seems to have many parts in it.
Yes, Reni. A computer is made up of different parts. The monitor, the CPU, the keyboard, and the mouse.
Here, this video is going to regarding about the main computer system, which we earlier studied. Just listen. If you have any doubts, ask me later, after end of the video.
A phone major parts of a computer. All these parts are very important.
Please tell me how these parts are important for a computer.
Sure, Rene. Let's start with the monitor. The monitor has a screen and it looks like a TV. It displays the output, whatever work is done or instruction is given on the screen. This board with alphabets and numbers on it is called a keyboard. The big and small buttons on it are called keys. Using these keys, we can write letters. We can make reports and presentations and also play movies and songs.
What is the CPU? It looks like a big box.
The CPU is the central part of the computer. It is also called the brain of the computer.
Okay, what is the brain of the computer?
CPU.
Yeah, very good. CPU is the brain of the computer.
the CPU tells the computer what to do.
What does CPU means, Clicko?
CPU stands for Central Processing.
What is CPU?
CPU Central Processing Unit.
Yeah, CPU stands for Central Processing Unit.
Unit. It is the most important part of the computer.
What does a CPU do in a computer, Clicko?
A CPU guides and helps the computer to perform different functions quickly and easily. The CPU is placed inside a box called the system unit.
What is this, Clicko? It has a wire attached to it and if like a tail. It looks like a mouse.
It is a mouse, Renny.
Students, what is mouse?
Rat.
It's a mouse. So here in this computer parts, this mouse also look like that rat, no? It also had a tail and shape also like that rat, no? Yeah, that's what we are calling. This one is mouse. Clear?
A mouse? How can it be? It is not a living thing.
It is a computer mouse, Renny. Look, it has two buttons on it and a scroll wheel at the center. It also has a small ball on the bottom, which moves the mouse pointer on the screen.
How does it help us, Clicko?
A mouse helps us to select any folder or content from the computer screen. For better movement, the mouse should be kept over a mouse pad.
I have seen Uncle Ravi's computer. He has lot of other things attached to the computer beside the mouse, keyboard or the CPU. What are those, Clicko?
Yes, Renny. You can add other parts to a computer if you require. Some of them are speakers, printers, joysticks and UPS. These parts are called a computer's peripheral devices.
Tell me more about them.
Speakers are used to listen to songs, voice, speech and sounds through a computer.
Okay, what's the purpose of speaker? What's the purpose of speaker?
We can hear songs.
Yeah, we can hear songs and we can listen. Okay.
A printer helps to print out documents on a sheet of paper. A joystick is used to move the cursor. It generally has three or four buttons. It helps us in playing video games on the computer. A UPS helps us to save our work safely when there is a sudden electricity cut. UPS stands for uninterrupted power supply.
Thank you, Clicko, for all your help. It is getting late now. I think I have to go now.
Sure, Renny. We will meet tomorrow and I will let you know more about computers.
Okay, the video is over. Do you have any doubts about that video?
No.
No. Swastika?
No.
Okay, memory?
No, teacher.
Okay, then smile, everyone.
Not finished yet.
Okay. I will want to finish the class quickly. I will want to finish the class quickly.
No, okay,
we'll finish the class. So 4:30, no, 3 to 4 no class. It's up to 4:30, so we'll finish the class here. Next class we'll see you soon with new chapter and new presentation. Now, do you have any question about today's presentation?
No, no teacher.
No questions, no doubts. Everything okay?
No teacher.
Okay. Then shall we go to the class?
What teacher?
Shall we finish the class?
Okay.
Bye.
Thank you, teacher. God bless you, teacher.
Bye.